This is how to use titration to determine molar mass. A 2.325 gram sample of a solid, weak monoprotic acid is used to make 100 mL of solution. But we don't titrate all of it. We take 20 mL of the resulting acid solution and titrate that with 0.10032 molar NaOH. The pH after the addition of 6.09 mL of the base is 6.50, and the endpoint is reached after the addition of 33.31 mL base. Okay. How many moles of acid were present in the 20 mL sample? Well, as you know, volume times concentration equals moles. So, I have 33.31 mils of hydroxide. That is my volume. And my concentration is 0.10032 moles of hydroxide per 1 mil of solution. I actually need to say I just have 33.31 mils of solution right there. There we go. That's a better way to represent that. Okay. And since we are told that it is a monoprotic acid, for every 1 millimole of hydroxide, there is 1 millimole of whatever my weak acid is. Okay, and I should make that millimoles as well. There we go. All right, now all our units work out. So I just have to take 33.31 times 0.10032, and I will get 3.342 millimoles, or 0.003342 moles of acid in that 20 mL sample. The next question asks, what is the molar mass of the acid? Okay, what exactly is molar mass? That's grams per mole, right? So if we know grams and we know moles, we're going to do okay. So grams we have. We have 2.325 grams of material. But acid is a different matter. We know we have 0.003342 moles of acid, but that wasn't in the whole sample. That was in just 20 mils. So I really need to ratio this, okay? It is 0.003342, and that is moles of HA, but remember that there are 100 mils of the entire solution over the 20 mils that we titrated. So we do have to make sure that we take into account the extra moles. So when I put that into my calculator, I wind up with 139.1 grams per mole. Okay, that's that part. All right, the last part asks, what is the pKa of the acid? Well, we are given 1 pH, so that would be maybe useful into getting the pKa. Let's see what I can do with this, okay? I have a weak acid. I am going to add hydroxide. My reaction is going to slam to the right to make conjugate base and water. Okay. I know from my first part that I have 0.003342 moles of acid. Okay. When the pH is measured right here, I have 6.09 mils of my base, which is 0.10032 molar. So if I take those and multiply them, again, volume times concentration, 6.09 times 0.10032 equals, and divide by 1,000, I will have 0.00061109 moles of hydroxide. So why don't I put that in my tape, okay? 0.0006109 moles. Okay, that is my initial row. That is zero. Now let me do my delta. And finally, my equilibrium final row. So that is zero. That is 0.006109. And this is 0.003342 minus the other one. And I get 0.002731. All right, now you notice that I have a weak acid and I have a weak base. So is that not a buffer? I bet the pH is equal to the pKa plus the log of base over acid. Rearranging this, I can say that the pKa is going to be equal to the pH minus the log of base over acid. So I've just rearranged my formula. All right, my pH is 6.50. Plus the log, my base amount is 0.0006109, and my acid amount is 0.002731, and if I type that into my calculator, I ought to get the pKa. And the value that comes out is 7.15. That is my pKa. Now, just for fun, this was a real acid. It's 4-nitrophenol.